Hi everyone, I'm Javi, and in today's video, I will show you how to make this. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. So the first thing we're gonna do is create an island. I will be using the Tilted Towers POI island in here in island templates. And let's name it Cinematic 2 Tutorial. If you want to follow along exactly what I will be doing, then use the same island template, but you can also follow the tutorial with any map you're working on at the time. Let's just press create. Now that the map has loaded, let's just move around the map. To move around the map easily, you need to press right click. And while pressing right click on the mouse, you can move with the WASD keys easily. If you feel your camera is going way too slow, you can go here, this camera icon, and change the camera speed. So right now, for example, we're going faster. You can also modify the camera speed with the scroll wheel in your mouse. So if you scroll down, you can go slower. If you scroll up, you can go faster. You can also use E to move up and Q to move down. And that's how you move around the map easily. Okay, first we're gonna create a folder to store all our cinematics. I'm going to press right click here in the cinematic tutorial content, right click, new folder, and let's call it cinematics. And now inside cinematic folder, we're going to be creating a level sequence. So let's press right click, cinematics, level sequence. I'm going to name this LS for level sequence, underscore, pizza, because I want to create a cinematic involving the Pizza Pit restaurant that we see right here. So now we're going to double click on the level sequence and we're going to be opening the sequencer right here. As you can see, the sequencer works very similar to any video editing software. You have a timeline and you have the ability to add different tracks. Here, since we're going to be creating a simple cinematic, we are just going to be adding cameras, just as in real life, right? If you want to make a cinematic, you need the cameras. And it's the same here. So the easiest way to create or start creating your cinematic here is to press this button, create a new camera and set it as the current camera cut. So let's just press this button. And as you can see, it created one track called camera cut and another track called Cine Camera Actor. And over here, as you can see, we can move around, but now we are moving around as a camera. You see here that it says Pilot Actor, Cine Camera Actor, which is the name of the camera that we just created. But we are right now piloting the camera. You see this airplane right here? It means we're piloting the camera, which means we are the camera now. As we are moving, we are the camera. Let me just click here to stop piloting and show you what I mean. So here is the camera we just created. And over here, you're seeing what the camera is seeing. So we're going to be animating the camera. You can move around the camera using the arrows, or even if you press E, you can rotate the camera. And that way you can animate the camera, but I think it's way easier when you are the camera. So when you are piloting the camera. If you want to pilot the camera, you just have to click here, this little camera icon next to the camera that you want to pilot, and you will be back to piloting the camera. So now that we are piloting the camera, let's just check a bit these properties that we have in the camera. Okay, so here in the properties, we can see the aperture. For now, we're going to leave it like that. I'm going to make another video explaining in detail all the camera components. We are going to be, in this video, just looking at the focal length. So the focal length will be how wide do we want our shot to be, right? So the bigger it is, it's like it's more zoomed in, right? It's like we're zooming with a camera. And the lower this number is, the wider the shot. So you can even go with a kind of a fisheye kind of view with it. I'm going to 35, which is the default one for this first shot. Okay, so I want my first shot to be kind of just like a a slow movement here, showing the Pizzapit logo. So the first thing we're going to be doing is going to the start of the sequence. For example, I want to go here to zero, to the start. I can press here, press zero, and enter, and I take the timeline right where I want it to be, right? So here at the start, I'm going to position the camera as I want my shot to begin. I think I want the shot to begin here. So now I'm going to be adding a keyframe for when I want my shot to start with, right? The position I want my camera to start in. So if we go here to transform, you can expand this and you see that we have other properties. We have location, rotation, and scale. So I want my camera to be exactly as it is right now. So instead of adding a keyframe for every of these properties individually, I'm going to click here. And clicking here adds immediately a keyframe for all those other properties. So I'm going to be just using the transform. Here, I just told to the sequencer, here I want you to save this exact position I'm in, right? Now I want to go to where I want my shot to end. So let's just go here, I think, to 3 seconds. And now I'm going to move my camera to where I want my shot to end. So let's say here, just a frontal shot of the Pizzapit logo, right? So now I'm just going to click here and that would be it. I just saved the starting point, the end point, and now the sequencer just animates from the first point to the second point, right? For example, I don't want my shot, as you can see here, the shot starts slowly and then it ends slowly again. That's because our keyframes are cubic. Here you can see that they are cubic. That means it eases out and then eases in, right? But I want them to be linear, to have the same speed throughout the whole shot, throughout the whole animation, right? So let's just press here, linear, and right click, linear. And now let's see how it works. You see, it's the same speed. That's how I want my shot to be, but you can experiment with different type of keyframes. So I'm really happy with my first shot, but let's say I wasn't. Let's say I want to change the end, right? Over here, if we choose, if we click these arrows, we can change and we can just scan through the different keyframes that we have. So let's say I want to change this end part, right? I want the camera to be a little bit more close to the logo. So right now here, let's see, I'm on top of the keyframe that I want to change. So I'm just going to change here, for example, I want to be closer. And now that I have it right where I want it to be, I can just click here again and it will replace the other keyframe. So now let's see how the shot is. Perfect, I love it. Okay, so now let's create another shot. If we want to create another shot, we need to create another camera. So just as we did before, I'm going to click here. And you see, we created Scenic Camera Actor 2. Before we jump into making the other cinematic, I want to do some stuff. First, I want to make this shot a little bit longer. So if you want to zoom out of the timeline, you can drag here, for example. If you want to zoom in or zoom out, if you want to zoom out more, you can press Control and scroll down with your mouse or scroll up to zoom in. So I'm going to zoom out, and here the length of your cinematic will depend on where this red line is. This line determines the end of the sequence, when the level sequence will stop. So I think for my second shot, I want it to be 4 seconds. So I'm just going to be putting it here at 7 seconds. So now we will be doing our second shot. We want our second shot to start right where our first shot ended, right? So I'm going to click here to go to this last keyframe. And as you see now, we are piloting here, it says Pilot Actor, Scenic Camera Actor 2. we are piloting our second camera. So for my second shot, I wanted to be a shot inside of the pizza pit to show a little bit of the inside of the restaurant. And as you can see here, I think the shot is not wide enough. So I'm going to be changing here the current focal length until I feel, say here, let's go to 17. Yeah, I like it. So I want my shot, for example, to be like here, and then just like pan a little bit slowly to the right to show a little bit of the pizza pit, right? So right now I'm standing right where our first shot ended, right? I'm going to position myself right where I want my second shot to start. So let's just go here, I think it looks great. And as we did before, I'm going to click here and transform to save this position in our second shot. So in our second camera, I'm going to press here, right click, linear. And now I'm going to the end. So at 7 seconds, and I'm going to position myself where I want my second shot to end. So I think I want it to end here. And now I'm going to press and transform again. Let's see, let's jump to the first one. And let's see how it looks. Yeah, I like it. Yeah, I like it. I like it just how it is. So if we go here, let's just talk about camera cuts for a second. Let's just talk about this track. This track determines what we are going to be showing to the player. For example, if there's nothing on camera cut, the player is not going to see the cinematic. The player is just going to see themselves, because camera cut is like having, it's like having a video track. So here you are animating the cameras, but here you are saying to the software, you are saying to UEFN, I want to show this to the player. So if we click here, for example, in the viewport, we can see what the camera cut is seeing. This is our first shot, right? And you see here, it doesn't change to the second shot. It stays on the first shot because this camera cut is only showing the first camera. So I'm going to go here to the end of our first shot. I'm going to right click here, edit, and split section. And now we have two different sections. In this first section, I want the player to see the first camera where we have our first shot. But here I want the player to see our second camera. So I'm going to right click and click on Scenic Camera Actor 2, which is our second camera. And now we see our second shot. So remember, we clicked here to see the camera cut, to see the whole cinematic. So let's just go to the beginning and play the cinematic. And that's it. We just created our first cinematic. Now, what we want is a way for the player to trigger the cinematic in game, right? So we will be creating that. I'm going to click here to unlock the view, to go back to the game view. And the first thing I want to add is here. Let's go to content browser, Fortnite, devices, and look for the cinematic sequence device right here. And let's just drag one over here. We can, it will be invisible to the player, but just so we can see it in the viewport as well, I'm going to drag it a little bit up. And this device will store a level sequence. So I'm going to click here in the cinematic sequence device. I'm going to go here to all, if you don't have it already. And here where it says sequence, I'm going to select the sequence that we just created. So here, you see LS Pizza. Now we're going to scroll a little bit, and here where it says play function, I'm going to add an element. This element is going to be the trigger to activate the cinematic. So let's just find that trigger. So here in Fortnite devices as well, I'm going to look for trigger, and I'm going to drag and drop this trigger right here, which is like a trigger platform. So I want my player to walk up to Pizzapit, and just as they're about to enter, the cinematic will play. It will show the cinematic of the Pizzapit, and then it will stop. Here, for example, we can press R to scale the item. So I'm going to scale it a bit to be a little bit more wide and a little bit more like bigger in every sense, just because I want the player to not miss the area, right? I'm going to press W to change location. I think here it would work well. So now we have our trigger. And here on the details panel, you're going to uncheck trigger VFX and trigger SFX, which are the VFX and sound effects for when you trigger it. I don't want them. If you want them, you can just leave them checked. I am also going to be unchecking here, visible in game, because I don't want that like platform to be showing. I just wanted to activate the sequence. Now that we have the trigger, we're going to click here on our cinematic sequence device again. And we're going to be here where it says play function, that we added an element. And we can just click here to pick an actor from scene, click, and then select the trigger. And now we have the trigger activated. So we're saying to the cinematic sequence device, so play this sequence when this trigger is activated. The way we're going to activate it, you can select it here where it says none. We're going to click and select untriggered. So when the player triggers this trigger, it will activate the sequence that we stored in the cinematic sequence device. Okay, so before we launch session, I'm going to be looking at our player spawner, which is right here, and I'm going to be moving it closer to a Pizzapit, because if we want to test out, we should be really closer to the thing we're testing, right? And let's just move it here in front of the Pizzapit. Okay, so now with the player spawner, now let's press launch session. Okay, so we're in front of the Pizzapit. We're going to walk and see if our cinematic plays. Yeah, it's great. Let's see it again. And there you have it. You just created your first cinematic in UEFN. Now you can create cinematics in your UEFN maps. And let me go back a little bit here on Sequencer just to show you what else you can do. You can also add audio tracks if you want to add sound. You can add fade tracks if you want to fade to black and stuff. I'm going to be creating other tutorials showing all other things that you can do on Sequencer. You can also use Sequencer to animate objects, and you can animate objects inside your cinematics. So I will be creating different tutorials to show you guys everything you can do with Sequencer and cinematics on UEFN. If you are interested in that, please subscribe to be up to date with all the videos that I upload. If you feel this video was helpful, a sub to the channel would be great. Right now, I think I have one subscriber. And also, if you like this video, it would mean a lot to me. So I'm starting, and I don't know if you felt that I was a little bit like nervous, but this is like my first tutorial ever. This is the first tutorial that I ever make in my life, and I will be making way more showing you all about UEFN. So I hope you enjoy it, and let's see you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.